Hi, brothers and sisters. I want to give you guys a very real message from my heart that I feel would be appropriate to share with you now. For those of you guys who have been watching my channel for a while and have noticed how, like, there was a point when I made videos all the time, and then there came points when I would just not make videos for a while. And then I would pop one out and I'd be quiet for even longer, and then I'd pop another one out. And so I wanted to share with you guys why I do that, especially now, since I have actually opened up a new channel and I've been much more active on that one. And Lord willing, I will continue to be very active on that one. But I want to talk about why I just go silent. Firstly, there is such thing as seasons, you know, like Ecclesiastes chapter 3, I think, where it talks about a time to speak and a time to be silent and, you know, a time to do this and a time to do that. Well, as far as, like, knowing that the Lord is going to return very, very, very shortly, that's not a new thing to any of us, you know, not to the bride of Christ. We know that he's coming. We've seen the dreams and the visions, and we've, you know, those of us that can hear his voice, we've heard him say it time and time again that he's coming, and we know it. You know what I mean? And we who believe, like, he doesn't have to tell us that every second for us to believe that he's coming. And so, yeah, that's part of the reason why I haven't been putting much more out. And that's not it. The other reason why is because I just... the things that I talked about in my previous videos in relation to the Lord's return, those things have continued to happen, but it's not something that's so new that I can just make video and video and video after, video after video concerning the same exact things. Because I've already shared with you guys about the numbers, I've shared a word from him a while ago, and just all these different things. But now, the other reason why I'm pretty silent on this channel is not by any means because I am not watching for him, because I'm watching for him every single day, you know. I'm watching for him with eager anticipation and great joy, great excitement, great longing. And while I'm doing that, I am just drawing nearer to him through faith. And so that brings me to my next point about faith. And how at this point we're just exercising a great deal of faith and just taking what he's told us and just continuing to live knowing that he's going to do everything that he said he's going to do. Now, another reason why, and this is where I'm going to just, like, start pouring out my heart here, why I stopped talking about dreams and visions and prophecy is because I have something better to offer you now. I have something better to offer you than just prophecy and just another dream and just another vision. I have something better to offer you, and that is sharing with you guys, also through scripture, how you can grow closer to your Heavenly Father. And that's what I'm doing now. I am on my other channel. It's called Soar in the Faith. S-O-A-R, like an eagle, okay? Soar in the faith. You can type that in and enjoy, like, pretty much a marathon of videos of me talking about faith, because that right now, that is very, very important. You know, we already know that he's coming. We already know that. We don't need another video to tell us that. And that said, I love, channels where people are encouraging the brethren who are still watching. Thank God. You know, but I want you guys to know that I am still watching, just because I'm not talking about the rapture right now. I am still watching. It's just that I have shifted my attention to what is also important, and that is physical growth and not neglecting your own walk with God. You know what I mean? And I've also learned a lot about the true bride and about the difference between a bride whose heart truly longs for the Lord, you know what I mean, and those I don't know, just perhaps there are those that like the idea of being called the bride, but don't honestly want to put in the effort that it takes to walk this walk. You know, to a lot of people, the idea of mansions and the idea of being a part of the holy city and the idea of being called the bride of Christ is very desirable to them, you know. But when it comes to like the Lord himself, for some, they don't really care that much about that, and that's why they only want to hear about the dreams, and they only want to hear about the visions, they only want to hear about what's to come, and they're all about the benefits of this, but not the real sacrifice and not the real walk, because for the bride of Christ, this is a very serious faith test. You know what I mean? If the Lord's told us that he's coming now, and like, on earth, we still see the calendars changing, you know, like we see the years changing, and what we have now is faith. What we need now is faith, and just knowing, like, Lord, you said you're going to do this, so I believe you're going to do it, and I'm going to live like I believe you're going to do it, you know what I mean? Some of us, like the true bride, we've been brought to the point where we love hearing that he's coming, we love that. And at the same time, like, we don't require it to know that he's coming, you know what I mean? And I've just been thinking on different things, like, another way that you could tell the true bride is that, like, what if, ask yourself this question, what if God just canceled out and stopped giving out any form of vision or dream? What if he did that? What would you do? You know what I mean? For the true bride, you would continue to press into him. You would continue to still want to learn more about him and how to please him, because we still are in these physical bodies. There are still things that we can do to store up treasures right now. There are still things that we can do to bring him glory right now. You know, we wouldn't, like, if he were to just stop giving out all dreams and visions, we would keep seeking. We would keep finding, we would keep learning, we would keep growing, we would keep coming into that fullness that God has for us to come into. We wouldn't despair, we wouldn't just look around and say, oh my gosh, remember all those dreams and visions where the Lord said he was coming, but now all of a sudden the dreams and visions stops, like, what does that mean? Does that mean that he's not coming anymore? Does that mean that we can just go back into the world because the dreams and visions stopped? No. The true bride is not going to do that. The true bride hungers for intimacy and closeness with the Lord. The true bride wants more of him for who he is, rather than just what he has to offer, like eternal life and, you know, just things that you can enjoy in eternal life. Because here's the thing, we're all going to sit in the judgment seat of Christ, right? And we are all going to have our lives reviewed and be given, and the things are going to be given to us according to things that we do in the body, good or bad, you know what I mean? And wouldn't you want to have an answer, like, if he were to ask us something like, okay, you looked for me to return, and I'm very pleased that you looked for me to return, because I told you to do that. I told you to separate from the world. I told you to keep your eyes on me. I told you to do those things. I told you to have faith. And, you know, he said, when the Son of Man returns, will he find faith on the earth? You know, I told you to do those things. But up until the point that I took you, what did you do? How did you live for me? What did you put down to bring me glory? What did you pick up to bring me glory? What did you do for your brother? What did you do for your sister? How did you use this life to be prepared or eternal life? What will we answer him? You know what I mean? I, for one, would like to have more to tell him than, oh, I just shared a few dreams and visions here or there. I want to tell him that I gave him my all, and I want, you know, and I know you guys do too, I want that when the time comes that we get judged. I want him to see every bit of that product and all of the fruit that was produced from having that faith and surrendering this life in any and all areas, and by obeying. And faith, surrender, and obedience is what I talk about on my new channel. And so just in case some of you guys didn't see the video before this, I'm putting out this one to let you guys know why I haven't been talking so much about the whole prophecy thing, but I've been coming with the real food, real spiritual nourishment, you know, of how we can use this life to honor God, and how something, you know, something that's often overlooked, and that is surrendering to God, you know, surrendering to God in all areas, and actually walking this out, like walking out this faith walk and growing nearer to Him, as near to Him as we can in this faith walk, how that seems to be an overlooked thing. You know, it seems to be overlooked, and that should not be so, especially not of the Bride of Christ. And so, yeah, I just wanted to pop out this video to just kind of share with you how I happen to be one of those people who, yes, I've had a channel where I've talked about the rapture prophecies and all those things. Praise the Lord for that opportunity. Thank the Lord for that, because I was able to meet so many of you precious, precious souls. And, you know, I loved every bit of that. And at the same time, I am not just a person on here that's going to do the bare minimum. You know, I have two duties. I have the duty to serve the Lord and the duty to help you guys, my brothers and my sisters. And that's not just a duty, like just a job or a chore, but it's a great delight to me. And so I'm going to do that with all my heart. So that said, you're invited to check out that other channel, because for people who might be looking for my videos, you can look at them over there. I talk a lot about the Bride of Christ and about faith. And I talk about the heavy stuff, you know, the stuff that maybe not a lot of us are making videos about, maybe because they're not led to do it, and I just am, or maybe because faith is just that overlooked, but yet it's so important. It's all throughout the Bible why faith is so important. So I wanted to share that with you guys, that right now, what I feel is so very productive and so significant is to talk the real talk about the behind the scenes things that we do, for those being called as the Bride of Christ, things that we do to not just have been prepared, but to stay prepared, because we are kingdom builders, and what we do down here will translate to something in eternal life. And so I just want to encourage you guys to keep on looking for Him, and at the same time to absolutely never, ever, ever, ever neglect the personal walk portion of this life, you know, because, you know, He'll take His bride, and then after that, there are things that we're going to do in eternity. And so in this life, we are gifted with the opportunity to learn as much as we can, depending on our free will and how much we want to press into the Lord and how much we want to seek Him and how much we want to find, so that in eternity we can apply all of those things. And so I just want to encourage diligence and to just say, you know, there's so much more that's available to us than for us to just be taken up. Like, we have a whole entire eternity of wonderful things that we'll be doing, and these are things that the more we seek God, we can learn more about those things, and we can become more and more solidified, more and more purified, and that is a wonderful thing. So the reason I've been quiet about the rapture is because I'm talking about faith and personal growth, and that is so important. So yeah, I want to share that with you guys. I might pop out another video with some scripture also, because there were some scriptures on my heart, and I might just talk about those in another video. But yes, you're invited to check out Soul and the Faith channel. In fact, I'm going to link it in the description box. And so, God bless you guys, and may you all be edified. Bye!